Hey everybody, Billy from Billy's Bike Adventures. Thanks for tuning in today and watching the video. Now today I'm going to be removing the front wheel off my BMW GSA and I'm going to show you how to do that. So if that's of some interest to you, keep watching and let's get into it. If you haven't subscribed yet to Billy's Bike Adventures, don't forget to click the subscribe button, the bell notification and then all to make sure you don't miss out on any updates. Now as I always do with these videos, I'll show you the tools that you're going to need to be able to remove the front wheel off your bike successfully. So when your bike is on the center stand, naturally the front wheel is touching the ground. So you're going to need something to prop the front of the bike up in order to take the wheel off successfully. Now I've got my wife's jack out of her car. So I'll use this jack with a bit of wood going across the top. So that'll sit at the front underneath the bash plate. And I'll raise it up just enough so that the, whilst it's on the center stand, I'll raise up the front just enough so the front wheel is off the ground, so you'll be able to remove the wheel successfully. Other items you're going to need. You will need a 17 mil wheel nut, so that is for the front axle wheel nut. You're going to need a 13 mil socket as well, and that is for the screws on the brake calipers. So that's what you're going to need for that. You will also need a T45 Torx head, and that is for the pinch bolts on the front axle. You're also going to need a torque wrench, and that is to torque the nuts back up, especially the front axle wheel nut and the pinch bolts, to the recommended manufacturer's specifications. As you can see, the bike's on the center stand, so what I've got to do now is position the jack and the bit of wood at the front of the bash plate here just underneath and just raise it up just enough so that the front wheel is off the ground. So let's get that done. Right, that's enough. As you can see now, the front wheel's off the ground, so we can now start taking off the front wheel from the bike. So we're going to take off the front axle wheel nut. You're going to need a 17 mil wrench nut to be able to do that. So let's get that done. Straightforward. As soon as it untightens, it's easy to take out. Sorry for the brightness. It's a very bright sunny day and I've got my garage doors open, so my face looks like I've got a high beam light on it. I don't. So that's the front axle wheel nut now off. Next thing we've got to do is the pinch bolts for the front axles. These are the two torque nuts at the front here, so one either side, so let's get that done. As a reminder, for the pinch bolts at the front here, you're going to need a T45 Torx head, one either side, so let's back those, just loosen those off. They don't need to be backed all the way out, you just loosen them off. Right there, that's one loosened off. Let's get the other side done. So with the front axle nut now off, the pinch bolts of the axle have been loosened off, not backed out. It's time now to take off the nuts for the calipers. So let's get that done as well. Last thing I've got to do is to remove the speed sensor. Now I get a couple of comments about this with my other bike, the KTM 1290 Super Adventure R. In the bike's manual, they call this the speed sensor. So that's what I'm going to call it. Some people call it the ABS sensor, but it's actually called the speed sensor in the manual. So we need to take out the speed sensor as well. That's the last thing we need to do before we can take the axle out and remove the wheel. So everything's now ready for me to take out the front axle of the wheel. So I've got a bit of wood, a hammer, and all I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap lightly on the axle nut just to start pushing that through. Right, that started to come through now. So I'll move these out of the way. And what I need to do now is just use my knee and my hand just to balance. It's still a bit tight, so it needs another tap. Right, there we go. So that's come right out the other side, loose enough for me to take out now. So I'm using my hand and my knee just to balance the wheel where it is so that the axle comes all the way out. And there we have it. There's the axle that's come out now. And the wheel will just drop down now and just roll on out. And that is how you remove the front wheel off a BMW GSA Adventure. Now, the beauty about having the front wheel off is that when you clean a bike with the front wheel on, hard to get to the insides here on the suspension. So whilst I've got this front wheel off now, I'm just going to give the front suspension a bit of a clean inside with where you can't really get to before I start putting it, show you how to put the wheel back on. So to reinstall the front wheel, simply a reversal of everything we've just done. One important addition though, and that is clean off your front axle and replace the grease on there. So there's a new layer of grease on this front axle now, so that is ready to go on. It'll be easy to remove the next time that we want to take the front wheel off. So let's slide this front wheel in now. Give it some room. And in order for me to get the axle in, just in case it's stuck, I've got a rubber mallet. Persuader, just in case the axle needs a little bit of persuading. So on my knees, close enough just to roll the wheel up onto my knee, front axle, and she goes. Right, a little wiggle, and with that new grease she's sliding in perfectly. Beautiful, that's in. So really important that you do give a new layer of grease to the front axle. That's just gone all the way in beautifully and ready for everything else now to be tightened up. So let's start with the front wheel nut. Front wheel nut, that just goes back in. I'm only going to do that finger tight. That's not going to go torqued yet. So that's that there. Next thing to do is that I'm going to tighten up the pinch bolts ever so slightly, and then I'm going to torque the front wheel nut, then the pinch bolts, and then I'm going to put the brake calipers back on. So let's get that done. So I've got my Torx wrench with the 17 mil nut on it for the front wheel axle nut. Now the recommended torque is 30 newton meters for the front nut, for the front axle nut. So I've got that set up. So I'm going to start tightening this up until we hear the torque click. There you go. 30 newton meters, and for the front axle pinch bolts, that is 19 newton meters, 19. So I've got my smaller torque wrench set up for that. So I'm now going to torque those, and I'm going to do these a little bit of a time. So I'm going to tighten them just a little bit. There you go, that one's tight. Right. And if you are putting the same nuts back in the same holes, so you haven't changed them, they should torque up to where the previous person had marked the nut on the frame. So mine are lining up really nicely. So now, next thing to do now is to put the calipers back on. So this one's already in the on the disc. So that sat back on the screw port. So I'm going to put the bottom one in first, the bottom screw back in first. And I'm just going to tighten that up finger tight, or as far as I can go with it, finger tight. Now, importantly, on the gear clutch side, the top screw for the brake caliper, must remember to put the speed sensor cable holder back in. So that, just pick that up with the screw. There we go, and that's back in. Now the first caliper's back on, but I haven't torqued it yet. Manufacturer's specification is 38 newton meters for the brake calipers. So I've got my big torque wrench set to 38. So let's torque these nuts for the brake calipers back up. Newton meters torqued. Let's do the other side. Now both calipers have been torqued to 38, so both on correctly both sides. The last thing to do now is put the speed sensor back in, and that is torqued to a newton meter of 8. So 8 newton meters torqued for the speed sensor. There we go. Last thing to do now is to take the lower the bike down off the jack so it remains on its center stand, and that is the front wheel taken off and reinstalled. So that is how to remove the front wheel off your BMW R1200 GSA. There's a card up top. If you're interested in learning how to remove the rear wheel, take a look at that video and be sure to let me know your feedback on that. If you've got any questions or comments about today's video, leave them below the description in the comments section and I'll be sure to get back to you as quickly as I can. Give me a thumbs up as well and share the video with anybody that might be interested in learning how to remove the wheels from their bike. Thank you very much for watching today and I will catch you again very soon.